Welcome back to War of the Visions with the Ultimate Chi. I'm thinking about, we did a poll video earlier today and I pulled a bunch of cards, and I'm thinking about upgrading my vision cards and see if that'll help me in arena versus the anti-mage build I was building before. So right now I have 80 shards here. I have 400 tickets here. So that's 200, 250, 300, 400. Yeah. And these last two, I can actually summon a guy on with it. So that's 150 shards worth of a Gaion, and then plus another 75 shards worth of a Gaion if I buy it off the shop. That'll get me to 225. I'll still be missing 50 shards to max out a Gaion. But even then, I don't have Orlando, so I don't really want to max out a Gaion. More versatile cards like Shiva and Secrets of the Heart. Shiva, I have 9 shards left. And Secrets of the Heart, I have 56. So let's say I'm missing 220. Right? So I was thinking about what's the best way to use those tickets so that I can get both of them. So I was looking at Secrets of the Heart, because it's in a spot where, like, I don't really have to waste extra shards. But then I pulled another one today, so it was like, okay, now I gotta think about it. So I have 400 tickets if I use, because I can't get 225, so I have to go to 250. If I use 250, what'll happen is I'll have around 30 free shards that turns into Mog Metals, and I had 80 Mog Metals as I shown you earlier. That'll buy 10 shards of Shiva. Here, so 10 shards of Shiva, that'll only get me to 119. I'm still short 6 shards, and if I use another 100 tickets on Shiva, I'll be short 6 shards, and basically I have to wait 2 days to use the guild medals to get the rest of the Shiva cards. And then I noticed something. Then I noticed that the Mog medals, the Esper summons are 100 tokens, but the regular tickets are only 50. But since that is the case, give me a big brain idea. So what I would do is, I'll get 150 Shiva cards. That way, I'll have about 30-ish extra Mog Metals. And I'll use the 100 Mog Metals to buy Secrets of the Heart twice. Then Secrets of the Heart will be at 76. And then I can just use 200. That way I save 50 tickets. And in that situation, because I saved 50 tickets, I can use that extra 50 tickets to finish off my mask. Mask of the Seat. So I think the game moves all around. So Shiva, I need 150 of. So we're gonna start summoning. And of course I bought the guild pass earlier this week, so I don't have an extra 10 million guild that I really, really needed to get. That I really, really needed to max out those cards. Is this one from the Shiva? I need 150 Shiva shards, right? So here's 100. Here's 50. No regrets. get any points on it. And that should give me enough shards. I think I kept popping the visions, the whimsy shop to get the Exorcist vision card that I ultimately matched up. But then again, it's vision cards, so they're a little hard to get. And I didn't have an AoE defense one, so it wasn't that big of a deal. Anyways, here we're gonna buy 200 of the heart. I think Katana actually looks really good in this picture. So that's a 50. So that's 150 total. I really hope that, like, that little animation there, if it's a gold book for these kind of guaranteed sign tickets, that they would just, like, block an extra 25% of silver and of Deceit. I bought my Mask of Deceit to 75 with the tokens that I have from pulling the hatcher, just so I can max it out when one of these vision card packs come out. And there's Mask of Deceit. So I got Mask of Deceit, Titan, Spear Team. The other reason I'm pulling for these evade tickets, these evade espers, is because the brutal quest, the challenge quest, is actually really, really annoying. It's not hard if you just straight up do it, but what is hard is I think I have Rainbow Vision Sphere starved, because I need to awaken the door as well. Can't believe I only got 3 million. Ugh. That's rough. Basically show you guys what I can do. Yeah, I don't have that kind of gold. Apparently I also don't have that many, of these mana. Shallow was done. This game gets very Game of Thrones, and you think like, oh, they're gonna die. Oh, they're dead. Oh no, wait, they're back. Like, I figured she was just gonna trap her, or Grey Shallow was gonna get taken. Especially when one of the chapters is literally called Devastation of Rubius, and then I find out two chapters are Devastation. Alright, so we're gonna run a new team here. Probably Leo, Alex, Ryu. Unfortunately, I don't have the gold to make Ryu into a... I think, a couple of abilities are going to make a difference. All of this, and we just hunt people that are slash based, and hope we survive one slash attack. Yeah, let's do that. For Howitz, I have the sword here. In this case, it's a matter of who's gonna attack, right? Because I have two of these swords. So it's a matter of, okay, which one are we gonna attack? Thank you.
which character has resonance with who. I guess Shiva. What I would want to do is give, if I give Shiva to Howlett, that will make him immune to, that'll make him resist, resist ice. Or give Tetrasylphid to one of them, because is Tetrasylphid the one that has a bunch of evade? Because she has a bunch of evade, and that'll help. What was I gonna do? Check out the stats, right? So, without Ramu, I'm still at around 900 magic. We got increased slash, increased magic. I'm only weak to win a little bit. So basically no weakness here. This is actually a decent spread. Another 20 from Shiva. So I should have a decent amount of evade. Howlett is looking decent. And it comes down to whether or not I want to use Solidus or Fenrir, right? I think Solidus is fine. The problem with this team, is if I'm hunting Slash, most of the people that are running Slash and I also don't have an agility card, so that makes it difficult. But with this setup, if I want to hunt Mage, I just switch it to Fenrir. I switch it to Solidus. The thing with Fenrir is, see how this goes. So now we're running no tank. Gonna run no tank and see how this goes. I think they each should have around like 40% dodge. I really need to go into a mission to check how much percent dodge for that. I guess we'll do that after the arena. That could be quite bad. He's not dodging anything. This is really high risk, high reward. Very easy for me to die.
This should be interesting.
I'm the one running evade and he misses? Like, what? What? You gotta be kidding me. Now you're gonna die. And you didn't even use the, zombie mask. Alright, one for. Wow, what? What? This is BS. Freaking kill face arrives with, like, no HP. Meanwhile, little Leela one-shots me? This is crazy! Oh, this is not gonna miss. Oh, god. CC. Well, hopefully, she can kill her. And then, we go from there. And Ryu is an idiot. I guess I'm hunting magic too much, but I'm going around picking fighters on the
high. What the?
Yeah, that's my line. Like, what the heck? How's your aim so good?
Bad.
My aim so bad.
I think the only one that has actual decent defense is Leela. So what's gonna happen here is my little Leela is gonna run out of TP. She's gonna keep attacking everybody, and then she's gonna run out of points to actually kill with. Alternatively, how bad is... Oh my god. And I'm the one running the evade team. Apparently it's a question of how bad is awkward. I guess that just means that Howlett and plus guaranteed hit. Probably rather fight Agrius. Goes to show that evade isn't all that good because you can't punch through anything. Are you kidding me? Okay, I gotta go, I'm gonna say respect, so basically switch up my zombie Wily with it. This is crazy! What the hell? Oh, that's annoying. I don't think this team can run as much evade as I thought it was. Maybe I have to get the meta and Shadow and in this case it's more of testing than anything else. So you got a guy that's about to die and instead of killing him you use the buff? What the heck? Is he out of MP? Well, that seems like a big waste of resources. That's awkward. Alright, I gotta go check to see how much evade they actually have. And go from there. To a certain extent, it's kind of, we're kind of just testing the waters here. Oh wow, the team of everything. Let's see. Oh, I've got to turn off auto. Yeah, let's go auto in the back then. Do from behind. I have a 100% chance to hit him from behind? What the heck? Go from the side. And this zombie Ryu has like no evade. What the heck? Going 50 for him. 30 something from the front. And a chance of hitting him from the front on 76. Yeah, I'm guessing much better for Howard then.
Scared yet?
It's worse for Howard. 86, 83, 97, 98, 57, 32. Is it the same for Howard? Chance to hit on the front. Definitely won't hit him, so it's that has to be the highlight. That's awkward. No wonder I was getting the left energy now.
Never underestimate a wolf!
Okay, I guess what we do here is go back to the first team, and then instead of I'm going to swap out the Solidus for Shiva and run that way. If I just have Shiva. I guess that build still really need Scion of House Beol. Because without it, I wouldn't have the agility. Better to run him as White Mage, even though he doesn't have full rise or Holy. That's Maverick again. See him everywhere. The same 100 people every time. It's not good. So that basically says that, like, this should be interesting. I wouldn't say the game is dying, I would just say that, like, either it's not as popular or there just aren't that many, like, super whales out there.
Well, well.
Think about where I can move him so he doesn't keep getting owned. Last time, I looked at Gammon Thrust on Kofi and she didn't die. I think this time, if Howlett was Gammon Thrust Kofi, because now I have Rommel. Oh, but the point is that you got to kill yourself. I guess no tank really doesn't fly here. Bad. The magic reflex. Goodness. I just run down my ring. I think my ring is running counter guard or the anti-physical one. So I believe he already has enough magic. It's interesting that she's using Holy instead of Aurora, even though she's weak at all.
I can't lose.
I think maybe I should just straight up turn off Gammon Thrust for Howlett. And then that way he'll save some AP. And instead I think he'll just run up straight, right? I guess that's how we would run him. Turning off the jamming thrust doesn't cause him to not run up there and hit hit somebody with the, This one's interesting. He's 289s, but he's running this Snow White Guard card. So he should have some insane resist. Ooh, slash resist 80%. Like, what the hell? Not weak to win. Naturally resist slash. This will be interesting. Let's fight Johnny. Here's Johnny. I think what will happen here is since he's got slash resist, my ring isn't gonna be able to do anything to him because I don't have Fire Aga active. I find most of the time me using Fire Aga is actually worse for him. His 700 magic is nothing to laugh at either.
This should be interesting.
He's a holy Deathmate killer. Wow, good. Okay, I thought he could roll the light. I was gonna say I've been getting hit a lot even with Shiva. So she's gonna heal, but I'm gonna see if I can kill him. Like 200 damage, wow. Okay, his kill phase not even like healing. Kill phase like forgetting. I'm just gonna hit you. Dude, insane. Wow. Okay, my turn to hazard slash. Oh, Yoga Blade. I don't have jamming slash. This should be a win, because somewhat resistant to magic. On top of me having hazard. This will kill him. So it's a matter of can I kill Alex? And I'm out of mana. Really? Oh god. Well, he's out of mana too. Oh man. I'm gonna lose this. Okay. Don't know if I have do I have initial AP up for I think that might be a good option. Here's the problem with Howlett. He does not have enough. He does not have enough AP to go around.
Thank you.
Actually, I think that's probably a bad idea. Because it's like... It's like, originally, I wasn't weak to kill Faye, but now I am. I think with this one, probably... Now what'll happen is little Leela is gonna cast Aeroga instead of Zombify.
Hear me growl.
Which wouldn't be an issue.
Those who stand in my way shall be destroyed. This should be interesting.
This is a purely offensive kill play. Instead of heal.
Never underestimate a
wolf! So there we go. Finally got a win here. And either we call it a day here or we go for a bit more. That was kind of, feels like it's kind of a waste when you do so much to cap out your attack and cap out your magic. And you still get wrecked. So sad. Okay. What the heck?
Preparations are complete.
Why aren't you going to heal?
Should be interesting.
Like, I don't have any other healers. And you didn't use Zombify, so it's like, oh, if he hits you, you die, and it's over. What the heck? And that would have been one of those times where he should use Hazard Form. Or just Hazard Form. What the hell was that? Did I accidentally turn her healing off? I know I didn't. So she must have thought she had enough HP to actually kill him. You just got two turns on my ring right there. Okay. Just completely got wrecked. What the heck is that? I'm definitely gonna get slowed by AGS today. I'm definitely gonna get hit by shot. Oh, instant death. But the little Leela's not healing or using zombies, so. He has to stop right there. Is he gonna... Okay, I don't think he has a chance to heal, he's just gonna die. Okay. What the hell? I moved her away and instead of being zombie or anything, she just happened. He's not feeling at all in the last three battles.
Bad.
It's kinda early in the week, so basically playing with AI. What the hell was that? It all on. I think if I lose one or two more, I might just switch back to Ilvira. Because it's like fine, I lose I can use a smaller bonus. But I can't keep losing like this. Let's not position again. It's evade. Running evade. And anti-magic, so it's like, evade plus Odin is actually a pretty good idea, because most of these attacks are single target. Because most of the guarantee attacks are single target, except for Ultima and I think and Energy Buster.
Hear me cry.
Maybe little Leela just gets hit above half, so she's not constant shield.
Wolves stand in my way, this should be interesting.
Okay, looks like he won't run up front. Why the hell is my rain attacking? Oh, that's crazy.
Bad.
you can walk like another step before you use that, right? Because now you're just gonna get Judgment Sword. Or Taunting Blade. Oh, you're all just gonna get Taunting Blade. The problem with having Ring so far back is it takes him forever to come up here, and by the time he does come up here, all my guys are dead. What the hell was that? AI is real dumb. Oh, and they didn't kill him. I totally should have killed him right there. If my whole life got canceled there, does that count? Am I still with you full life? Oh, she's finally out of AP. Oh, I thought she was going to be a summon. Ouch. Can't beat him.
Why don't you give up now?
Oh, my Howlett is not strong enough to be fighting. Oh, you're still back to A0.
Not so bad.
I don't think Shiba is really doing much. Don't really see my other guys dodging anything. Alright, we're gonna go back to A0. Accuracy problems. Actually blocked the stop ability. Some revenge. Aegreus, because of all the status effects, is actually stronger than Rain. Meanwhile, my Rain almost never uses Undermine. Not that Undermine does anything. Low Rain. I guess that's the good thing about having your healer there, because it's like, I'm double AoEing on the side of the wall. So if you want to fight back in the AoE wall, you're gonna die.
Fired up. All according to calculation.
Oops. Oh, Aegis got lucky you didn't hit her, because she's on type 3. Yeah. Hitting that hard AoE as a tank, like really? Crazy. Aegis hits like a freaking truck. Finally. Water God Blade.
All according to calculation.
Oh god. Bad. And she still didn't use her.
Take this! Enemy successfully.
Narrow win. You can see the difference in the points I gained. The last battle I won, I got 330-ish. This one I only got 200. Well, at the end of the day, it's better that I get something than nothing. Let's see how Skull is built. I fought a couple of Odiras, they didn't like have Skull and they didn't do much on me. I need a TMR wand. So I can go.
Hear me growl.
Ring smart coat on Odira. Interestingly, he didn't do his,
Why
he didn't
do
that move, the LB. The flare.
I shall hit you.
Wow, I had a feeling I might have gotten one-shot it. But damn. What the heck? Are you kidding me? Oh, that's a PC. I think we're gonna have to stop here. I have to do some more research on how this AI works. It's not just to operate. Well, I guess that's it for today. We made some, maxed out some vision cards, but. Ooh, this is awkward. I gotta figure out how I'm gonna fight this man here. Gotta make them resist the urge of just straight up running up to them. We'll see. Until next time.